whether you win that game or lose that game, a draining affair, obviously.
Right.
What are the bigger challenges for both teams, your team obviously, especially coming back, I guess, 19, 20 hours later after that marathon last night?
Well, it's the World Series. You know, nobody gets much sleep. The players probably get more sleep than I do. I mean, I think I went to bed at 4 and I was up at 6:30. But it's a fun time of year. I mean, that's what makes it so much fun. It's, you know, it's kind of exhausting, but it's exhilarating at the same time. So, you know, the 2 hours of sleep felt much better winning that game than they did losing that game.
And the center, Al Jorge?
Ned, Alex Gordon mentioned yesterday how he had seen Familia quick pitch, the previous hitter, so
right.
He was ready for it.
Right.
What are your thoughts on the tactic from both sides? Because you also do have a right. pitcher in Cueto who does it. Who
uses Again, it. I don't have any problem with it. You know, for me, what pitching's about is disrupting timing for the hitter. And most of the time, pitchers do it with fastballs, changeups, sliders. Some guys do it disrupting their timing and their delivery. Johnny Cueto does it. So, you know, it's just a part of the game. And it, I don't think, for me, I have no problem with it. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, but see, in those situations, if you do your homework like they all do, they know what they're, you know, what they're capable of doing and are normally prepared for it.
Here in the front on the left, Barry.
Ned, what do you know about Volquez's availability going forward, and Chris Young, can he still start game 4?
Yeah, yesterday our plan for Chris Young was that if we needed him, we would use him 45 to 50 pitches, and he would still be available in game 4. It'd be just like a short start and then coming back a day early. He hadn't pitched in 6 days. We wanted to use Chris in that situation so that knowing that Chris would be available for game 4, we would have Chris Medlin long for games 2, 3, and 4. So it just was, you know, a perfect scenario there. Last thing Eddie told the guys last night when he left is, I'll see you in New York. So I fully expect Eddie to be there ready to go for game 5.
Andy?
Just two quick ones. Do you have Kelvin tonight?
I do.
Okay.
He's right in my locker room. He's here.
That's nice.
Yeah.
You know, 35
Andy,
pitches.
Yeah, what we'll do probably with him, it won't be a multiple inning scenario like it was last night. It could be, you know, to get us out of a jam. It could be for an inning. But out of all those relievers, Kelvin bounces back better than all of them. Is why we try to, why we use him the majority of the time in those multiple inning or multiple, you know, 4-out, 5-out situations.
And when you woke up at 6:30, why didn't you try to go back to sleep?
Well, because I had to pack, and there's 18 people coming over to the house for breakfast this morning. My wife was up, Andrew was sleeping on the couch, and then all of a sudden Jenny and Jordan came in, and then here comes everybody else. And, you know, sometimes it's hard, but you just put a smile on your face and, hey, everybody. Yeah, yeah.
In the back row on the left.
Ned, Collins talked about Perez and said it's no big deal about the pine tar incident. Are you surprised that it was even brought up?
No. No, they look for any stupid thing to bring up. But it's nothing. I mean, you know, it's not illegal for a catcher to get an extra grip. Now, pitcher, it's illegal. But Sal's not putting anything on the ball for the pitcher. I mean, he uses it for his own, he just taps it lightly so that he gets a better grip when he throws it, which is completely legal.
Barry?
Ned, last year you and the Giants were so equal, you went down to the last pitch. Last night you and the Mets, same thing, down
right.
to the last pitch. Do you expect this World Series to go all the way down just like it did last year?
It's going to be tough, yeah. Each and every game is going to be, like it was last night, a grind for both teams. I mean, both teams, because we are so equally matched. And we don't expect it to be easy by any stretch of the imagination, no.
On the far left, Danny.
You did it for a potential 3-run lead 2 games ago, pinch running. Last night it was the potential lead run as the back run. How do you balance that particular move with Kendrys being out of the game?
Well, again, last night was a situation where you know they're bringing Familia in the ball game, and the odds of bunching together 2 or 3 hits to not only tie the game but take the lead is probably not going to happen. So you go for the win right there. You put Dyson in, let Dyson steal second base. Now you got runners at second and third, and it takes one hit to get Wade Davis in that ball game. So we were just going for the win right there, and you don't get it, and then you get what you get. You know, you go through two other at bats without Morales in the game, but you know you can't play it safe when you're in the World Series. You go for the win.
How about the previous one where it was going to be the sixth run?
I don't even remember the previous one. Was the sixth run?
Well,
I'm pretty sure we were going to win that game, so I didn't worry about Morales coming back and having to get any more at-bats.
Buster on the center aisle.
Can you give an update on Perez's hand?
He's fine.
Okay.
He's
good. And also, Escobar looked like he might have rolled his ankle.
Yeah, he did
bases.
A little bit when he hit third base, but he's fine too. Okay. Everybody's great. Everybody's good.
On your far right, Ned.
Ned, last night when you said that the club was contacted by Volquez's family, are you talking about family back at home or family?
No, Dayton. I think Eddie's wife called Dayton. Told him what had happened, and then Dayton came right in my office and told me. And you know, at that point, I got Don Wakamatsu and Pedro Gafal in the office because you know they're guys that I trust with every decision that we make. And what do we need to do here? And all of us came to the decision: we just got to honor the family's wishes. She didn't want to tell Eddie; she wanted Eddie to pitch that game, and that he would be informed afterwards. As soon as the game was over, his wife and his kids and his brother, they brought them into the clubhouse, and they all went into my office and shut the door.
Standing on the left, Alden.
Well, what has been your assessment of your Don Ventura's postseason so far?
I think he's been throwing the ball really well. You know, he's a guy that's got 3+ pitches. You know, if he's commanding his curveball, that's the big key for him. But you know, he's had to face you know, a tough Toronto lineup, a tough Houston lineup, and I think he's throwing the ball really, really well up to this point.
Is there one last question? No. Okay. Nope. We'll wait for Ben's.